Hi, this is Pilo Manyeneng and I'm the head of Property and Momentum Investments. So what have we seen happening in listed property equity markets since the beginning of this year? Well, we saw a very aggressive sell-off pretty much throughout the first quarter of 2020 with a bit of a bounce during the month of April, but clearly not enough to erode some of the losses that we've experienced so far. So a pretty gloomy picture from an equity market perspective, with the sector having lost about 48% of its value year to date. Well, what has caused that? I think whether you're sitting in South Africa, in Poland, in the US, UK or Romania, governments across the world have largely moved to impose regulations that seek to curb the spread of the coronavirus. So some of the measures that have been taken include prohibiting trade in goods that are deemed non-essential, but also includes prohibiting large gatherings either in workplaces, at events or at shopping centers. So if you can imagine, this has made it very difficult for the tenants that are occupying space in our direct and unlisted property portfolios to generate revenue, and therefore having a spillover effect on the rental income that we are able to receive. What does this environment then mean for the asset class? Well, evidently, the COVID-19 pandemic has affected the real estate assets into which we've invested your capital, whether you're looking at it from a listed perspective or from the direct property portfolio perspective. But broadly speaking, we think that the environment that we are heading into will be somewhat of a challenging one for businesses across the board. And as I like to say, property companies are landlords to the broader economy. So as economic activity slows down in general, their businesses and profitability levels will also be affected too. It's also worth noting that at this point, none of us actually are certain as to what the ultimate impact of COVID-19 will be on property fundamentals, such as future demand for space, the outlook for rental growth from here onwards, expected recovery period, and the valuations of the asset class. But what we can say is that in the short to medium term, we expect that fundamentals will be under pressure, and then cash flows and capital values will also experience some level of pressure in the short term. So while this is the reality that we're facing, I think our job is to sift through the noise and look for opportunities in the market. So if we focus our attention in the listed property sector for a moment, our view is that although COVID-19 is going to disrupt cash flows, we remain very constructive on equity valuations. At these levels, our view is that the listed property sector offers the cheapest entry point into the real estate asset class, and we think with the sell-off that we've seen in the last couple of months, markets have largely overreacted on the downside and have implicitly written down asset values of REITs to levels that we think are unsustainable. So from here onwards, we think that there's a significant capital return upside, and this is notwithstanding our view that fundamentals will be weak and then income, or rather cash flows and capital values, will also come under pressure. So what have we done in our listed property portfolios in the last couple of months? Well, our outlook for the South African economy has been negative for quite some time, and we've been worried about the implications of that on the listed property companies. So we took a decision early on to increase our position in companies that display the kinds of characteristics that we think will prove defensive in this environment that we're in, but also provide great upside over the long term. So if you look at the metrics of our portfolio as it stands today, the companies that we have invested your capital in are in a much better shape than their peers. They are in a much better liquidity position. They are less exposed to sectors that will take pain in the short term. They have a longer lease expiry profile, and they are not aggressive in their utilization of debt in the capital structure. So pretty much we used the weakness that we saw during the month of during the first quarter of this year to increase our weightings in these companies, and we did that at very attractive valuations. This, if I may just add, is our investment strategy, and we don't foresee this changing in the long term. If we turn our attention to the direct property portfolio, for example, for a moment, it becomes very clear why investors need to diversify their exposure across asset classes and within asset classes. Our unlisted property portfolio is, as you can expect, is much more stable because it's not affected by day-to-day market volatility. And I think in this environment, the added advantage that our direct property portfolio provides is that it is ungeared, and which means that it does not face the same risks that are faced by some of the listed property companies or property companies that have debt in the capital structure. Why do I say that? I think given the phase of the cycle that we are in, with no debt in the capital structure, capital losses will be limited to the downside, on the downside. Secondly, we do not have any debt obligations to lenders, which means that we will be able to pass through rental income that we would have collected through to you without that being trapped by the lenders. Lastly, I think although COVID-19, the impact of it is actually unknown at this stage, what we've also done in the direct property portfolios is that we've anticipated the short-term impact of what this virus will cost to cash flows, and we have moved to adjust our valuations lower to ensure that the current valuations best reflect what we believe is actually fair value at the moment. So in closing, I think we remain very willing to engage with you, so please get in touch with us if you need to engage further. We've got a very experienced team of real estate investment professionals who will be able to assist you in this very challenging times that we are operating in. So until we meet again, stay safe and have a blessed day.